What's up, boys and girls? Jess here with Mixed Reviews, the show that takes reviews from around the net and smushes them into one number. Now this week we're going to get rid of our downloadable game backlog with Dust and Elysian Tail, Hybrid, and Popo EO. Then we'll get to the big game this week, Transformers: The Fall of Cybertron. But before we get into the mix, don't forget to like the episode and subscribe to Start. We love each and every one of you, except for that guy. First up, let's talk about a very pretty game called Dust and Elysian Tail. The amazing thing is that this game was hand-drawn and animated by one lone dude named Dean Dodrill. IGN's Vincent Ignito was a big fan of the game. He said that it's hard to believe that such a content-rich, well-polished title could come from one person. Vince loved the graphics, combat, and exploration, but didn't really care for the weak bosses and RPG elements. Still not a huge complaint because he gave the game an 8.5 out of 10. Now the rest of the mix average was around the same percentage with an 84%. EGM gave it a 9 out of 10, saying that this is an adventure brimming with enjoyment from beginning to end. Their biggest complaint was the uninspired boss battles. Now Team Xbox gave the game an 8.5 out of 10. They said that while it may not be one of the most original games mechanically, this is a labor of love that stands out as one of the best downloadable releases of the year. So overall, the mix average says that this is a beautiful game that should be played. Just don't be disappointed by these somewhat blah bosses. Now next up we have Hybrid, an online-only shooter which puts a lot of emphasis on moving from cover to cover. IGN's Nathan Muner said that while it has generic factions, weapons, and presentation, it actually is one of the most unusual and interesting online shooters out there. He loved the emphasis on movement and how firefights flow at a crazy pace. He gave it an 8 out of 10. Now the rest of the mix average was pretty strong with a 75%. GamesRadar gave it a 4 stars out of 5, applauding the original gameplay. Game Informer was more negative with a 6 out of 10. They didn't care for the long matchmaking times and said that while fun, the multiplayer modes lack innovation and staying power. Overall, Hybrid seems to be a shooter that looks generic but has a really interesting hook. Rounding out the downloadable games is a PlayStation exclusive, Popo EO. Now this game actually deals with some serious subjects like child abuse, so kudos to them for taking that on. However, opinions on the actual game are all over the place. IGN's Mitch Dyer was a fan of the game's ambition, but not of its execution. He said it's a technically disastrous and wholly uninteresting adventure game, even if it does have a very moving conclusion. He gave the game a 4 out of 10, which qualifies as bad on IGN's scale. Now, like I said before, the review scores were all over the place, finally settling on a 69% mix average. Game Informer gave it an 8 out of 10 and called it a triumph of the imagination. They did find the game to be highly linear, but were actually okay with it. It said that familiar puzzle solving with unconventional storytelling is a compelling hook. Meanwhile, Joystick gave it a 3.5 out of 5. They said that it's far from the perfect game and could use some greater complexity in terms of gameplay. However, they also said that there's a powerful experience here. Okay, so there's not really a clear consensus with the mixed on this one, but most reviews are saying that it's a moving experience wrapped in a problem-filled game. Read some of the reviews in our YouTube description to see if it's the one for you. Okay, that's it for downloadable games. Let's get to the big console release of this week. Transformers: The Fall of Cybertron is the sequel to War for Cybertron, also known as that one Transformers game that didn't suck. Well, according to IGN's Matt Cabral, this game doesn't suck either. In fact, he said that this game is better than War for Cybertron in the areas of presentation, storytelling, and production values. He also said that while the levels feel a little more linear, having the focus be on specific characters makes for a more absorbing campaign. He gave the game an 8.5. Now the rest of the mix average was lower with a 77%. The official Xbox Magazine gave it an 8.5 and said that it's an epic story with beautiful visuals. However, the solid multiplayer is not on par with the campaign. Giant Bomb scored it much lower with a 3 out of 5. They said that while there's some excellent moments, they had problems with the controls, especially when it came to vehicle modes and the lack of a cover system. Nevertheless, the rest of the reviews make this out to be a solid shooter with great production values. Transformers fans will probably want to check it out. Okay, that's all for this week. Once again, don't forget to subscribe below or click here to see Greg fulfill his bucket list at Up at Noon, or click here to see last week's episode of Mixed Reviews where we talked about Darksiders 2 and Sleeping Dogs. I'm Jessica Chobot, and we'll mix it up again next week.